Hey there. You friendly? Truck's run out of gas.
Fuck!
So guys, the Walking Dead game came out a little while ago. This is a new storyline. This not related to any of the previous stuff. You're a new guy, Lee, who's, you know, he's coming back from prison, actually, or I think he's about to go to prison. They're taking him out of Atlanta. He committed some kind of crime. And this is right at the beginning of the zombie apocalypse. You don't really see that in the comic book or the show, but here you're driving out of Atlanta and you see all the cop cars going by, you see the helicopters, you hear the radio.
You'll have to learn to stop worrying about things you can't control.
It takes you through this lush comic book world. It's literally the comic book, but brought to life with color. And it really reflects in the graphics and visuals that Telltale games did with this. And getting back to the core of the story, from what we know and what we love about Walking Dead, it's the decisions that these people have to make. And I think about it and it's like, I can't be the jerk when I'm playing this game. I can't. Like, I really like the connections that you have with these characters.
What's the matter?
Should I stay?
What?
I don't want to sleep in the treehouse tonight, but I don't know if I should leave. What if my parents come home?
I won't leave you, though.
You have to justify yourself to other characters. There's severe repercussions for all your actions, and even killing just a zombie is, you know, significant.
Hi there.
Zombie kind of lore is really always about the good ones, at least, like Romero. A lot of those are, it's not about the zombies themselves, it's about the people in the situation with the zombies. It brings out the most extreme aspect of all these characters.
Son of a bitch, one of them is bitten.
He wasn't bitten.
Hell, he wasn't. We have to end this now.
Over my dead body, we'll dig one hole.
No! I'm cleaning him up. There's no bite. He's fine.
Don't you fucking people get it? We've already seen this happen. We let someone with a bite stay in, and we all end up bitten. Shut up. We gotta throw him out or smash his head in.
Kenny, stop him!
Hey, what do we do about this guy?
Dad, it's just a boy.
We reason with him.
With the bloody end of an axe handle, maybe. Nobody threatens my boy.
I really specifically remember a part in the Walking Dead comic when Rick is saying to his wife that he's really disturbed that he now thinks of everyone like in a rank, kind of like he has to like judge, like, okay, this person's the most important to me, this is the second most, this is the third most, in case he's ever in a situation where he needs to decide between two of them. And I mean, this game, and especially the way it's going, it really feels like it's gonna make you into that kind of person. I think that's really interesting. It's making you devolve in the same way that these people are.
Honestly, at this point, this blows the second season of The Walking Dead out of the water. I mean, just speaking for myself, can any of you stand Lori anymore? Because I can't.
I'm interested to see where the branching storylines are going, like how far they're really going to take it with that. And I mean, if they're that different throughout the five episodes, that's going to give a lot of replay value. And for the price that this game is, I mean, that's a great deal.
Yeah, I can't wait. I feel like this was literally The Walking Dead to the T in a video game, and I loved it.
Run!
You don't know who these people are. It could be dangerous.
Whoa, take it easy. Just want to help.
You can't.
Think this through.
He's bitten! We gotta throw him out!
I'm gonna kill him, Cat!
You wanna get violent, you old fuck? Well, come on!
I don't know who you are or what you did, but you better become a better liar fast.
I'm sorry, man. I'm sorry I wasn't here.